Hello, this quick tutorial describes the field testing requirements to verify a network cabling system's ability to reliably deliver electrical power to network devices using technologies such as power over Ethernet or power over HDBaseT. Let's begin with an overview of the direct current or DC resistance testing required for this type of verification. It must be emphasized that DC resistance testing is not a mandatory field testing requirement for the purpose of certifying a cabling system as category compliant. However, any organization that wants to verify whether or not its cabling links or channels can handle power delivery can do so by performing this type of testing. DC resistance testing verifies that the 8 conductors that make up the 4 twisted pairs in a cable have an equal or nearly equal amount of resistance. An excessive difference between the DC resistance values of the 2 conductors in any pair, or between any of the 4 pairs, can result in communication delays or link failure between network devices due to data corruption caused by signal distortions. And as an added bonus, this type of testing will also verify the metallic composition of the conductors and identify any non-code compliant or counterfeit cable construction, such as copper-coated aluminum cables advertised as 100% copper. Our next stop is the first of 3 DC resistance tests that can be performed on network cabling links or channels to verify power delivery capability. The DC loop resistance test sums up the individual resistance values of the 2 conductors in a pair after they're looped by the test instrument at one end of the link or channel. Note that loop resistance values increase proportionally as the length of the cable link or channel increases. Since the 4 pairs in a cable are twisted at different rates, the measured loop resistance values will usually be slightly different for each pair, with a higher twist rate resulting in a higher resistance value. However, a significantly higher loop resistance value for any one pair may be an indicator of the faulty termination of that pair on a connector located in the link or channel. The maximum allowable DC loop resistance values for permanent links and channels are listed here. Note that the Category 8 limits are lower than the limits for Categories 5E, 6, and 6A because of the shorter permanent link and channel length limits for Category 8. In the example shown, the DC loop resistance for pair 1, or the blue pair, is measured to be 3.89 ohms, with a small variance between the resistance values of the 2 individual conductors. This is well below the 21 ohm limit for a permanent link and 25 ohm limit for a channel, so this pair passes the test. Next, we have DC resistance unbalance, the second of the 3 DC resistance tests. DC resistance unbalance for a pair is calculated as the difference in resistance between the 2 conductors in a pair. Recall that DC loop resistance was the sum. Ideally, the 2 conductors should have equal resistance and there should be zero difference or no resistance unbalance in any of the 4 pairs. But in the worst case, the difference should be no greater than 200 milliohms or 3% of the DC loop resistance of the pair, whichever is greater. Note that in the example shown, 3% of the 3.89 ohm DC loop resistance is 120 milliohms. So the pair passes the test with 30 milliohms, which is lower than the maximum allowable 200 milliohms. Next, we'll conclude this module with the last of the 3 DC resistance tests, which is the pair-to-pair DC resistance unbalance. The third DC resistance testing parameter is also called DC resistance unbalance, but here it's measured between any 2 pairs in a cable, rather than between the 2 conductors of any single pair. Note that there are 6 possible combinations: pair 1 versus pair 2, 1 versus 3, 1 versus 4, 2 versus 3, 2 verses 4, and 3 verses 4. Ideally, all pairs should register identical values, and there should be zero difference or no resistance on balance between any of the pairs. But in the worst case, the difference should be no greater than 200 milliohms or 7% of the calculated total parallel resistance of the two pairs under test, whichever is greater. That's it, we're done. Thanks for watching.